devices are there in the dramas, that they are in the prose passages, you, that is the short stories, as well as the speeches and the poems, compulsorily in the poems it's there, and even in the novel. Anything you read in literature, you get the techniques, right? You get the literary features, you get them, because through them only, when you read stories, you get them, right? Through them only, the writer tries to create an effect. Now we will move on to the first one. First one is a simile, right? Simile is a comparison using as or like. Now, you do see the picture of the snail here, right? I'm sorry if it's slithery and slimy and not a good thing to look at early in the morning, but it's so fascinating that I put it, because it's so like, I mean, we never get to look at a snail in this way, right? So you look at the features and you see the slithery skin, the slimy looking skin, right? So you can compare something to another thing using the word as or like. Okay, so you say as slithery as a snail, or you say slimy as a snail, slow as a snail, right? So using as, I have compared something or someone, right? We don't actually compare people like that. It's a bit harsh. But when you write, to make your writing interesting and lovely, you can use this. Now you're learning for literature to appreciate. But with that, you can learn it. You can use it in your essays also for English, okay, to make your writing very colorful. Then it becomes so nice and elaborated that people would like to read your what you write. But don't make it too much of details. A lot of details will make it boring also, right? Just you just have to have it to a minimal level, a good level, right? So you compare the activities or the looks or the skin, the shell or whatever of the snail to something, and we as or like. So a comparison using the word as or like is a simile. Okay, right. What do you see here? Another picture, right? It's a lion, right? So you can compare. You can say, what are the words you can associate with the lion? What features do you know about the lion? Brave. Yes. Yes, Chevindi. Brave. What more? Okay, Tashmila also says, Aksha also says, strong, strength, bravery, courage. Lion is the king of the jungle, right? So we can say as brave as a lion, as strong as a lion, as ferocious as a lion, right? As, or you can say like a lion, right? He was brave like a lion. He was proud like a lion. So a lot of ideas can come. But a simile is always you use the word as or like, and you compare one thing with another. Did you understand that technique? We are not telling that this person looks, even you can say he looks like a lion, because we had a cricketer who looked like a lion. Who's that cricketer? The hair and all that. Do you know that cricketer? Yes, you all know your cricketer as well. Yes, 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 Malinga, right, okay. Right, so with the hair and all that, so he was the lion then, right? Sri Lankan lion, right? So you can compare using as or like. So to identify a simile, this is the first technique. I'm actually teaching you the techniques according to their strongness, right? So when you read something, a simile stands strong, a metaphor stands strong. So I will move on to the next as well. A simile is an easy one to identify because you get a comparison using these two words. So what you have to look for is the two words, as or like, right? Because you're comparing something with another thing using the words as or like, right? Understood? But not always in English language. Sometimes you use the word like or as, but it doesn't always bring in a comparison. Then you can't take it. But if you're comparing two things only, it will call it a simile, right? We are moving on. In your anthology, I think you understood, right? In your anthology, I've given several examples. Like thunderbolt, he falls. Now, you get it in the handout, right? But what you have to do is, I've not given you the poem. Can you find the poem for the first example? Like thunderbolt, he falls. Go through your poem if you can. If you have got a printout, Some of you have the hard copy itself, the proper book. What poem does this example come from? Like a thunderbolt, he falls. I've forgotten to put the quotation marks. Okay, Dulatmi, Sarah gave the correct answer. Aksha, very good. Aksha is 23, so that's really good. Abhushana is also in O-level 23, starting batch. Tarindu, okay, the starter has given me the answer. Very good, excellent. You are smart. Okay, you can identify fast. So that's the poem. So what you have to do is write the name of the poem. And also, I want you to now in my handout, I think I would have put the quotations. Whenever you're writing something taken from someone else, you have to put the quotations, right? So I'm not doing something right there because I've forgotten to put the quotations, right? So you have to have the quotations there because it's not my writing, it's someone else's, right? So like a thunderbolt, he falls. A thunderbolt is fast. So this eagle, it comes in the poem, the eagle. The eagle's flight is like zoom, very fast. A comparison, right? Like frightened bees, coming in a different poem. You have to find the poem. It's a comparison to a bird, right? The bird's eyes are like frightened bees, it seems. And the same thing, like one in danger. Yes, very good. You all have identified the poem already. Like one in danger is again a reference to the same bird. The bird got scared and as if he was in danger, he wanted to fly out. A mother whose heart hung humble as a button. This mother, in another poem, right, has a very sad situation because the son has died. And therefore, the heart of the mother is like reduced to a small teeny weeny button. Very good. Now, I know you all have identified the poems, right? I don't want you to do that now itself. Those who are in the senior groups can remember and identify and send me. My juniors, I want you to listen. My starters, I want you to listen and understand the technique because this is your basic. Okay, you have to understand the technique in order to have a smooth run for the entire O-level career until you finish your O-levels, right? Your study period, you need them. Okay. So if anyone didn't understand the technique, you just have to send me a message to the chat and I will discuss it again with you. Slowly only you can find the poems and write them in front with a different colored pen. Okay, write the name of the poem, put a dash and write the name of the poem with in a different color. Okay, so I'm asking you to do that because you need to get familiar with the anthology. You're not going to do it today. You're going to listen to me and get everything to your mind and later you can watch the recording and write the names of the poems or maybe after a month, then that will help you to remember. Those are memory boosters, right? It'll help you to remember the poems and the examples because these are examples from your book itself, from the anthology. Sometimes when you get questions for the exam, you're asked, you're given this line, like a thunderbolt he falls, the question would be from where are these lines taken? First one. Who wrote it? Second one. And then the third question will be, what is the technique found there? The fourth will be, who is compared here? Okay, so like that, right? Or what is the theme that can be, that you can